Addies, Grunts, Admin, Sweet Banana Gaming here with more of my Pokemon Soul Silver Randomizer Nuzlocke, and I lied to you guys, or rather, I changed my mind. I did not do any grinding in between episodes. I'm still at the lighthouse, and the reason for that is because I was going out to prepare to do some grinding off screen when I got a phone call from Bauba. In case you don't remember, he's the Safari Zone guy. Oh, hi, sweet. This is Warden Bauba. Sorry to have kept you waiting. We finally opened the Safari Zone. Do you know where it is? You know, the gate inside the cavern in Cedarwood City? Yeah, so I don't know why we had to go all the way here, and I guess they wanted to make sure we finished our little, medicine delivery quest first. So I restarted and figured that, hey, I'll do another episode here instead of doing some grinding, and we'll just do the Safari Zone in this episode, and then the next episode will be, after this episode we'll grind up, and then the next episode will be taking on Jasmine. So, yeah. I did not mean to go in there. Because we're all healed up. Alright, let's go and do that stuff. So let's see. I gotta think of another question of the day, because I'm recording this right after the previous episode, because like I said, I was gonna do some grinding after the previous episode, and instead I decided I'll just record another episode. But we can get another encounter here too. Let's see. Question of the day. Let's see. What do you think about the Safari Zone? Do you like the Safari Zone? I kind of like the Safari Zone, but I'm kind of torn on it because it's an awfully frustrating way to try to catch Pokemon. But on the other hand, it's kind of neat because it changes things up a bit. So I'm kind of 50-50 on it. It's really agonizing, but I can see how it's a fun thing. So that's question of the day. What do you think about the Safari Zone? So we're going to fight this guy here, Rich Boy Pie. And Kecleon, only level 19, so it looks like we're going to be up against some lower level Pokemon over on this route thing. So this is the perfect place to do a little bit of grinding. I guess it's not the perfect place, because they're still kind of low level. Alright, so we just barely missed on taking it out. I meant to hit Body Slam, but I pressed the A button too quickly. And a Swellow. Alright, that's upping things a little bit, but only level 19, so we can take it on, and it's gonna double team. Don't make me switch into Mr. Bohemia there. I had to do it in the previous episode. I had to use Mr. Bohemia in Aura Sphere when people were trying to play the evasion game. And, ooh, a Chatot. Oh, so, an update on my shiny hunting stuff. When I went out of town, I had to do overseas flight, so I did a lot of shiny hunting, trying to chain with the Poké Radar while I was, you know, on the trip. And I actually did get some shinies. I got I actually only got one Pokemon after a chain of 40 out of those. I'm trying to remember. I want to say it was Execute, because I think I got Slowpoke after a chain of, like, 20, and Inkay after a chain of 8, or maybe I'm reversing those. But, okay, oh, we're in Cliff Cave, which, we can get an encounter in Cliff Cave. So let's do that now. I think we can get something, I think. But yeah, I forget what order and I forget what chaining. I got Shiny, Execute, Inkay, and Slowpoke. And our first encounter here is a Hitmonchan. That is pretty cool. We don't want to stay in against that as a Rolly. Let's go use Kopeta and Glare at. Oh, went for Pursuit. That's actually not the worst thing it could have done. So, all right. Get the Intimidate off as well, a little bonus. But I have another funny story. I started chaining for, I think it was a shiny Tauros, and I kept breaking my chain. But at one point, I started the chain over, and the very first shaking patch, and it wasn't a shiny patch or anything, the very first shaking patch, I ran into a shiny Chatot. So that was really random, but that was kind of cool. I was not looking for a Chatot, but that was kind of one of those fun, like, I was shiny hunting, but I found that one by accident. Alright, so we've gotten this thing pretty down. We also lowered the defense, so I don't want to go for another crunch on it. Let's try a Great Ball, because we only have 3 Ultra Balls. Oh, nope. Not yet. Not yet. Let's try that again. Can we get it? Three shakes and still nothing. Alright, we can still take a couple more hits from this thing, though, before we have to heal. So let's keep trying. Alright, Hitmonchan was added to the Pokédex. Let's go. I was not prepared for this, so I did not open up one of my previous videos before. The most recent video up at time of recording is still only episode 12, unfortunately. But hey, this is what happens when I record ahead of time. There's still some names that I haven't used yet, though. I remember. Let me see if there were any on episode 12 that I haven't used. Let's see. We used you, we used you, we used you. Okay, so episode 12, we have everybody. Like, we've already used everybody who commented on that one. Episode 11, I think, had some new ones. Kid Team Katie, yeah, but you're a, that's a female name there, so I would rather have, did I use Rounded Plate's name? Oh, well, anyway, I'm gonna use Cameron Mason. Unfortunately, did not answer the question of the day, only said second. But hey, you did comment, so that's something. I'm gonna name you Cameron. I can see that being okay for a Hitmonchan. It's also the name of the photographer guy. So anyway, thank you for your comment, and I have not gotten around to replying to all the comments that people left while I was away just yet. I will get to that at some point. I mean, again, probably by the time this video goes up, I might have had the chance to. Okay, and also, this is Route 47. I don't believe there's any grass, so we're gonna go and go for a surf encounter here. So we will get a chance to encounter something else, and Rolly is gonna just go out into the water for us and let us surf on him. Alright, let's find something, and I think there's also items we can get, so we'll look for that as well. And then after that, we can just kind of spam repels to make things go better. Alright, what is our encounter for Route 47? I'm pretty sure we haven't gotten something. It's a Minun. Alright, not too exciting, but it is something. Let's try and just throw a ball at it first. And then, if that doesn't work, we'll paralyze it, because I don't think we can do much else to this thing. Yeah, we're gonna have to paralyze it. Unless, actually, we could probably, we'll have to throw in Coppetta and paralyze it. And then, I guess, we could probably use maybe Quick Attack on Luigigon. Either Quick Attack or just use Fury Cutter one time. I think that would be enough, but let me see if this Great Ball will work now first. Alright, that's enough. Okay, so this one is a female, so I can go back to Kid Team Katie. I can name this thing Katie. So the question of the day on episode 11 was, what's your favorite glitch in a video game? And Kid Team Katie says, I'm almost positive you're not supposed to catch the electric legendary dog, can't remember the name, that would be Raikou, early in the game, but I threw a quick ball and caught it, and well, then the game crashed. I was gonna say, when I first was reading that, I was gonna say, that doesn't sound like a glitch, but then the game crashed, so maybe it was, who knows. You definitely did something to break the game. But anyway, you are named after a Minun now, Katie, congratulations. And let's see, alright, I guess, no, you're not named after a Minun, actually. The Minun is named after you. So I'm gonna put up a repel in just a second, but let me use a couple potions here just to get everybody up. Actually, I'll use a super potion on Coppetta because she could use it there. Alright, and then we'll start putting up some repels. Yeah, let's go for the super repels. Actually, I could put a Soothe Bell on something, but I don't think I don't have anything that evolves through friendship. So, it wouldn't do a whole lot of good. Do I have the TM for return, though? I don't know, that could be a good thing. But, oh well, I'm not gonna worry about that right now. There doesn't seem to be anything here, unless there's a hidden item. I don't know if I have the patience to search for it with this lag here, but okay, we found a pearl. All right, we can sell that. Oh, by the way, thank you, Kid Team Katie, for your comment and answering the question of the day. Don't forget to answer the question of the day. And did I come up with the... Yeah. How do you feel about the Safari Zone? That is it. And also, if you want to include comments about, like, well, like, Safari Zone includes the Great Marsh and all that stuff. Okay, we can't do this part yet. So Safari Zone, that would include the Great Marsh and, I guess the Safari Zone and Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, even though that one doesn't really work like a Safari Zone, really, yeah, we haven't had a proper Safari Zone in 6th Gen, but also, I guess I'll include the Safari Zone, or the Friend Safari from X and Y, even though that's a different thing, but I did think the Friend Safari, it's not a good replacement for the Safari Zone, but it is kind of cool. Like, you can get Pokemon with 2 perfect IVs there, and Pokemon that you wouldn't be able to catch otherwise in the game. Like, the middle stage starter evolutions. So yeah, I actually really like the Friend Safari, even though it's not really a Safari Zone. Alright, let's try to go up these stairs and see what we have. Actually, though, we should go across that bridge also. Oh no. Double battle. Remember, this could be, well, I've seen non-randomized, those guys can be pretty nasty in a double battle. But what I want to do first is I want to make sure that I didn't miss anything across the bridge here, because it seems like that's the way I have to go. So I think there might be, okay, there's an item here, and another trainer. But we can fight this guy. I'm not good with large crowds, blah blah blah, camping, da 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 da. Okay, Swimmer Alex, and he's got a Loudred. No problem, I guess. Let's go Surf. He's gonna go for the Howl. Getting progressively scarier. Alright, no problem at all for Rolly, actually. And a Hoot Hoot. Well, we're just gonna Aurora Beam that thing, and that should be fine. It's gonna go for the Reflect. Not gonna matter, really. We're hitting it on the special side. And that is that. Alright, so now let's grab whatever this item is. I've been watching people who play, oh, Revive, can't really use that. I've been watching people who play randomizers with all the items and TMs randomized. And I don't know how you could do that, man. I mean, that's just so stressful. I don't know. Like, I like the TMs being what I know they're gonna be. And the items especially, because the items, the items you pick up aren't super necessary, but a lot of times you pick up items that you need in certain areas, so it's nice to have that reliability. Oh, it's a Meryl, which we already have. Alright, so let's run. But yeah, and then there's people who play with randomized movesets, which, I mean, if you want total chaos, that's the way to go, but no thank you for me, that's not for me, I don't think. Maybe another time. Alright, let's see, what's a good double battle pair we have here? I think I want to have Mr. Bohemia up front. And then what do we have to worry about from you? Electric or Ice types? Let's have Michael, I guess. You don't have the best defenses, but you can Dragon Rage stuff. Alright, let's go with this pair. Scary, guys. I don't think we could avoid it. I mean, I could have tried, but... I mean, their levels aren't that... The levels haven't been that scary, so maybe we'll be fine. Levels on this route have been kind of low. Jinx and Dewgong. Well, we need to... And they're level 25. Great. Well, we need to get Michael out of here right now. And put who out instead? Actually, I think Rolly would be pretty good. Or Mythmaster. But actually, I think Rolly would be better. So let's go for Rolly. Yeah, go for the Ice Shard. That's true. Ooh, that was a crit. Why'd you crit? Alright, Rolly can't escape, but Mr. Bohemia could. Let's see if this is enough. No. Alright, we gotta use another Aura Sphere on the Dewgong, and then we've got to heal Mr. Bohemia. Hopefully this will work. We've got exactly 50 HP to heal. Alright, come on, Mr. Bohemia. You can do it. It's gonna Ice Shard again. Oh, no. Okay, good. The Dewgong did not... Well, obviously the Dewgong didn't go for Ice Shard, because Ice Punch hit first. Okay, so now, actually, we should be good to go back into Michael and take care of this Jinx. And as for Rolly... Oh, wait. As for Rolly... You can't go for Surf, obviously. But... Because of Michael. But how about... I don't know, Body Slam it. Yeah, Ice Punch not gonna do... Ooh. Well, it was a crit, so it did more than I would have liked. Ooh, we get a good chunk of damage with Body Slam and the Paralysis. Good job, Rolly. Alright, so we should be able to take this thing out no problem. Oh man, Michael, come on. You have the Charcoal and everything, and you couldn't take that thing out. Maybe Jinx's Special Defense is pretty good, I don't know. Okay, got Rolly level 29. I still don't remember what level Rolly evolves at. Maybe 32, 35? I don't know. It's not now, that's all I know. Alright, let's go ahead and regroup a little bit. Let's potion up a couple of our Pokemon. Yeah, and then let's potion up Michael. Alright, now who do I want up front? Who do I need to keep training? I've had Rolly up front. But let me rearrange things a little bit. Actually... You know, I did grind up Mythmaster a bit, but he hasn't gotten any on-screen time just yet, so let's put him up front. Our good old Mythmaster. I think he was the first one we named after one of our viewers. I'm pretty sure. But anyway, we got our Mythmaster here. Chugging along up front. Go on the bridge, darn it. There we go. Alright, there's an item over there, which, can I surf across and get it? Actually, I can just walk across the bridge. Why would I need to surf? Why would I want to surf when I can walk? And actually, I don't think I can anyway. Yeah, it's a cliffside, so... There is some grass outside the Safari Zone. But we already got our encounter on the water, so we don't need to do that. And it's starting to get a little dark outside. It's not actually dark outside, but the sun is getting low, so... Oh, we've got another double battle. Would you look at that? Alright, I want to... Let's put Mr. Bohemia... in this again, and we'll hold on to Mythmaster because he can put things to sleep, so we'll try that. Oh man, am I gonna regret that? I'm getting nervous now. I'm getting nervous that I did that. Why did I put Mythmaster up front? Because honestly, offensively, Mythmaster has not quite reached his stride yet. I mean, maybe... And we got two bugs. Actually, we should be alright with this. But... Mythmaster has not quite... he did learn Extra Sentry, but he's not quite doing the job here, offensively just yet. Let's go for... I guess we can try an Air Slash, because that'll be better than Aura Sphere. Alright, we should be able to take out the Armaldo now. All it's got for us is Water Gun. Okay, we're doing pretty good now. Let's just, let's try to Hypnosis this Krikatoon in case it has something like Bide. And I'll fly with Mr. Bohemia. Give us a chance to do it. Okay, he's going for the Leech Life. Okay, we got it to sleep. That is good. So we should be able to hit this thing all we want until it wakes up, of course. I don't think it has, it probably doesn't have Bide at this level, but you never know. Alright, we took it out. Crisis averted. There was Mr. Bohemia's first on-screen battle since we brought him back to the team. And now I think we're at the Safari Zone. I got that item, right? Yeah, I don't feel like going back to check. I'm pretty sure I got it. Okay, oh, Route 48. So I think we can get another encounter here. And is this guy... Oh, it's Cameron the Photographer. Look, I'm sorry, guy, but I named a Hitmonchan after you already. I don't really have time. I actually have to... Because I wasn't intending on having a full... episode here. I have to hurry up and finish this, but we can try to get another encounter. So let's see what we run into. Our encounter for Route 48 is a Hoppip. Well, a little bit anticlimactic, but we can try to put it to sleep. Unless we miss. Alright, I'm gonna tackle. And another tackle. That should be enough. I mean, it's just a Hoppip. Let's go and throw a Great Ball at it. Alright. So now we have to find something to nickname this thing. So, excuse me for a moment while I look on my comments here. Let's see, do I have anybody else for episode 11? There's Rounded Plate again, but I don't really know what Pokemon I could give a name like that. Let's try to go back again now, then, to episode 10. Keep going back in time here. Let's see. Oh, right. Mike Anthony Laura asked me to nickname a Pokemon Titan, and I'm not sure whether I should use up that great suggestion on a Hoppip or not, but that would be really adorable irony. I don't know. Let's see. I don't know. I could name it Titan, but I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna check out, what else we have here for episode 9. Nitro Ross, a lot of my really faithful guys. Ooh, how Killer Watt, that would have been an awesome thing to name, what was it? To name, that Minun that we just caught. But, how about this? How about Level Up? I'm gonna save Killer Watt for an electric Pokemon. I'm gonna save Titan for something that's, you know, actually a little threatening. Although, again, I think a Hoppip named Titan would be adorable. But this person, Level Up, says, awesome video. And I really appreciate that. Nice compliment there. So, as a thanks for your lovely comment, I am going to name this Hoppip Level Up. A little bit of a weird name, but why not? Don't worry, I will not forget the name Titan. And I was just about to nickname the Hoppip Titan because it would have been funny. But the thing is that it would have been really funny if I were gonna use it. But right now, I think I'm good on grass types, so I don't know that Hoppip would be the first thing I use. I mean, Jumpluff is kinda cool, but right now I'm happy with Luigigon. So I would have named it Titan if I thought that I was gonna use it at least right away. If I was gonna use the Hoppip right away, but I'll name something Titan that I think that I'll probably, I don't know. I'll save the name Titan. It'll either be for something that's appropriate or for something that's hilariously ironic like a Hoppip. Oh right, Safari Zone Gate. I think we can buy items here, right? Like special kinds of items. Let me take a look here, this lady with her beautiful Butterfree. I wanna buy something. Can you wait while I get ready? Well, I don't know why we had to do that, but we also might as well sell. We got a pearl and a nugget, so let's get some money there. Lagging Tail, we probably don't need that, but I won't sell that or anything right now. Alright, let's see what you have for sale now. Quick Ball. That actually would be a nice thing to have. Let's get 5 Quick Balls, because those could really come in handy. Quick Balls are so good, honestly. Alright. Let's, I don't know, I want to check out the other shops. I guess I don't have to. I want to just get right down to the Safari Zone. It's getting dark outside, it's getting dark in the game, kind of. And we've been at this for like 20 minutes or so, maybe a little more. And I want to do the Safari Zone thing and then finish up. So again, the way the randomizer is, they're going to ask us to catch a Geodude. We can't do that. However, we can catch something. So we won't be able to use the Safari Zone beyond that first task, I guess. Which is fine, because we only get one encounter anyway, so it's kind of a problem that solves itself. Oh, we can't use the Safari Zone. Well, we can only catch one Pokemon in the Safari Zone anyway, as per Nuzlocke rules, so no harm done. So let's go ahead on in there. Now. The Safari Ball is kind of cool. It's got like this camo print. Alright, here's Baoba, and I kind of forget what voice I gave him before. Hi, I've been waiting for you. What do you think? This is a brand new Safari Zone. By the way, I just had an idea. Would you like to take the owner aptitude test? Sure, why not? Right on, let me explain how the test works. It's very easy. All you have to do is to catch one Geodude at the safari and show it to me. They're in the grass closest to the entrance. It shouldn't take long before you catch one. Good luck. Yeah, well, apparently that job might turn out to be more difficult than you might have thought. So, I don't think anyone's gonna be, unless we get really lucky, quote-unquote lucky, and a Geodude can be found in the safari zone, the randomized safari zone, yeah, you're gonna have a hard time turning over that ownership of the safari zone for sure. Why do I get the feeling that this Balba guy doesn't want to own the safari zone? He just, like, wants it to be someone else's problem. It's curious that we don't, like, have to maintain... In this safari zone, we do get to change the layout of it, but before we can do any of that, we have to just catch a Geodude, but really, we're just gonna catch whatever we find first. And it's not a Geodude, but it's Graveler. I don't think that counts, but it's the first thing we ran into, so I'm gonna try to catch it. Although, really, the way that the Safari Zone rules work for Nuzlocke, like, if it flees, it doesn't count. It's basically the first Pokemon we can catch, but I have to just keep throwing Pokeballs at things until I catch something. So I can't, oh, if I don't want that encounter, I can't run away and wait for something else. It's basically I just throw balls until I catch something. And as for bait and rocks or whatever, I won't use any of that, I guess. Although this Graveler is getting really annoying. Yeah, and he fled. So yeah, the Safari Zone, it'll be the first thing I successfully catch. But again, my only choice, I can't run from anything. And I have to just throw balls at it. Oh, look! It's a Geodude. What are the odds of that? Actually, is the Safari Zone even randomized? I don't know. But I will probably catch this guy. Alright, well hey, we caught a Geodude, what do you know? I'm gonna name it Rounded Plate, yes. I'm gonna name you Rounded Plate. I found something to name I won't name you Titan, I'm sorry. I'm gonna name you Rounded Plate. If I can fit it, let's see. I think I can fit it as one word. So I'm gonna name you Rounded Plate. That is funny. What did Rounded Plate comment anyway? I forget. Let me find Rounded Plate's comment. I think it was on this episode, episode 10. Maybe it's not. Maybe it was episode 11. Maybe it was episode 11. I will find it. 1 second. Rounded Plate 844. Oh, you said first. Well, that's fine. Rounded... Well, oh yeah. I miscalculated. It does not fit. Rounded Plut. There you go. There you go. Or I could nickname something first. But alright, we got the Geodude. Let me just see if this even is anything like randomized grass at all. We found Geodude and Graveler, which I think are both... And there's a Geodude. Is there anything else? Or is that literally all we can run into? Like, is it programmed that that's all you can run into until you pass the aptitude test thingy? One more encounter here. Alright, it's a Geodude. Well! Alright, something tells me that that wasn't randomized, but I'm gonna count it anyway. Because, yeah. I'm fine. I'm fine. Just, I don't feel like going back and, like, trying to get a different encounter instead. That would be, I have so many encounters right now that I don't need to anyway. So, I guess let's just, temporarily get out Rounded Plut here. This is a PC, right? No. Oh, no, that's the machine where we, like, change around the Safari Zone. Okay, so I can't show him the thing, actually. I think we can't show him the Geodude, can we? I guess, well, this episode ran a little bit longer compared to the previous episode, but let's do it. Let's real quick here, as quickly as my game will run. Come on. Come on. Okay. Let's get that thing out now. I'm not gonna update the layout or anything, because he's just there to just finish the Safari Zone quest. Which we don't really have to do, but I feel like it would be wrong if I didn't finish it. Now look at this whole box of Pokemon we have. We really are not hurting for things at all. Alright, let's get Rounded Plate up in here. Rounded Plut. Actually, Mythmaster would have been a funny thing to name Rounded Plate, because that's kind of what he is. Alright, let's do this. Come on. Come on, really? You saw that. I, like, just teleported to the other side of the door. Going through doors is the hardest thing. I think because I technically have this whole thing running on times two speed, so it probably skips two frames when I make one motion or something like that. I don't know. Let's show him this Geodude and get it over with. They really ought to have a PC right there. But anyway, we caught a Geodude, blah, blah, blah. Passed the test, huh? Didn't I tell you there are two tests? Oh. The second test, well, I'm still preparing for it. Well, that's fine. That's fine. I don't really need your stupid test. Okay, let's go and let's save a little bit of time. Let's fly back to Olivine first. No, don't look at stats. Let's fly to Olivine first, and then we'll go ahead and put Rounded Plut back into the PC. Okay. Sorry for the silence there. I've just realized I'm out of things to say right now. Basically, I'm ready to finish off the episode now. So, now this time, I really will do some grinding in preparation for the Olivine Gym. And so in the next episode, we should have all our Pokemon up to level 30, maybe a couple a little higher than that. And so we will take on the gym, and it'll be a complete surprise what type it's gonna be, because there's no trainers to fight against and scout out. Alright guys, if you liked this video, go ahead and leave a like. Don't forget to answer the question of the day, which is, what is your, no. How do you feel about the Safari Zone? Do you like it or hate it? Whatever. And if I've already named a Pokemon after you, please leave a nickname suggestion for something I can name a Pokemon. I have Titan. Titan is in my mind. I will name something Titan. I just figured with that Hoppip, I would name it after someone new who commented. But I will keep Titan in mind. Hopefully I'll run into, like, a Pichu or something and I can name it Titan. But anyway, also, subscribe if you haven't already. If you're not a grunt of Team Eclipse, we would love to have you on board. Also, check out my channel, Sweet Banana Gaming, because if you like my content on here, you'll probably like my content over there as well. And I'm gonna get out of here, guys, so thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next episode of my Pokemon Soul Silver Randomizer Nuzlocke.